there's a unified type of, unfortunately, a unified struggle, and experience that we can all share in and understand.
Hello, my dear.
How are you?
Oh, it's so good to see your face. So, Mangrove, what a film, my goodness. I thought it was so incredibly powerful, and it was so great to see you in this kind of role. Talk to me about, like, what struck you most and attracted you most to Althea?
What struck me most is that we didn't hear about this story prior to receiving the script. It wasn't something that we knew within our community or given to us as young Black people in this country to know about what was happening back then, what they were fighting for. So that struck me. And also, what made me want to tell the story again was just, you know, the fact that you don't always get the opportunity to play someone like this or represent someone like this and someone who had something to say. So I was very intrigued by that. I knew it was filled with purpose. I knew it was filled with, you know, the opportunity to teach people through what we were doing. And yeah, just represent our people, you know, represent the Caribbean culture.
Yes. And you know, what struck me also is that I think with this collection of films here in the US, there's constantly this little battle going on in Hollywood about the Black British actors and do they have the, you know, do they have the understanding or the, you know, collective experience to play, you know, Black Americans who have been oppressed and who have been discriminated against. And this is one of the first times that I've seen laid out so clearly the ways in which Black people are discriminated against and oppressed in the UK. Does that make you, or I guess in a way, do you think that that is something that you're hopeful can kind of inform what I think is this wrong opinion that you all don't get it?
Oh, man, again, I just want to be about peace and love. You know, I definitely want to be sensitive about how I answer that because there's an understanding there on the side of our African-American brothers and sisters who are in the industry and who feel like that. So, you know, for us, I know for myself, I can only speak for myself. I just see myself as an artist. And I see myself as someone that just wants to be a vessel for good stories. And wherever that story is and wherever I can be a vessel, I try to be that. At the same time, I am grateful that this series can, yes, inform our brothers and sisters across the diaspora that, you know, we struggle in all parts of the land. We struggle in all parts of the world, whether it's in Brazil, whether it's in Africa, whether it's in, you know, America or Canada, wherever we are. There's a unified type of, unfortunately, a unified struggle and experience that we can all share in and understand. So hopefully, yes, it does bring insight. And hopefully, yes, we can just see each other as fellow artists and respect each other as such.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. You take care of yourself.
You're welcome.
Okay, bye-bye.